few cash going, so here we go. We're going to see Neko guys starting off on T side and Savage logos on the CT side here. So, again,
I like the Neko guide logo. It kind of looks like a Latin American pro wrestling mask.
Really?
Yeah. But unfortunately, oh yeah, well, the darker blue one, which you can't see in the avatar.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. I see it now.
It's that a bit Rey Mysterio, isn't it?
That can't be unseen.
Yeah.
That cannot be unseen. All right, let's going into the match right now. We can obviously see a very spread setup here. The Neko guys, as they're just like feeling it out. Any aggression from Savage, which is very possible at the start of the round to see an aggression, but we can see obviously that Savage are taking this very slow themselves. This is very defensive, actually. Look at how they're holding really far back here. Cutler and Levi there. So obviously the bomb is towards B. They're probably looking at a B split through the vents here, moving in their way mid. That would be what would be reasonable from a setup like this. And it is a very powerful, very quick hitting play. So looks like they are going straight in right there.
B, the bomb is on the B bomb site already.
Yeah, they're straight on in. See JD there, just tossing that nade up. Do they have any smokes to go in there? They block off that choke point. Looks like they don't. Oh, look, they actually got a CZ on JD, and he has the armor here. So that's good stuff to see. And it looks like it's going pretty well for them so far. It's a 2-on-2 situation. We're seeing a Neko guy very easily just walk into the site, get the bomb down, and just like easy mode.
That was an interesting purchase, because obviously it's worth mentioning that the CZ has been brought up to $500.
Yes,
so
yeah,
they've obviously made a deliberate tactic of him buying armor and another teammate throwing him over the CZ, which is quite a fair tactic. You know, it's still a one shot death for everyone in that first pistol round. So again, we will see the evolution of the use of the C chooser.
Yeah, I think it's fine. It's an interesting weapon, though. I don't know. I guess we could, again, as you said, you could talk about it for a while, the pros and cons of a strategy like that. But as far as the anti-eco goes for Savage here, they decided to just buy the pistol. They didn't invest further than that. No nades. We're not seeing a stack from them either. We are seeing a bit of a push coming in here. And Hades is actually going to make himself a pick.
He's always been there.
Yeah, so this is pretty nice that he was able to get far back in there and pick off a frag. That's already a bit of a win there coming in for Savage. He were trying to do any kind of economic damage that they could possibly pull off. And so one or two more frags would be perfect. Let's see if they're able to accomplish that. So three left at the moment on the bomb site. Do more. Trying to make things happen. Everyone seems to be broadcasting at this. Is everyone
still
streaming?
Yo, is that talk on, Mitch? Hello, Glory.
Yep. Yeah. Well, I hope so. You know, they're all being encouraged to, so... I think this is probably more exposure than the North Americans have got previously, but
I mean, everyone's got Twitch TV in there.
Indeed, yeah. now that FACEIT have moved over to North America and brought the leagues and ladders over there, they have a lot more eyes on them than they previously had.
It's awesome,
so
yeah,
any opportunity to try and gain a few fans,
it's so
absolutely worth it.
It's so new age. I mean, it sounds like
ooh,
weird
new
to say
age.
That.
Wow, you're
I know it's like weird, right?
Phrases.
But I feel like old and everything because back when I was playing, to be able to see a player that you admired in any sense actually like playing from their setup with their config, that was like what people would do is they would download the config of the player and then maybe even buy the same mouse and setup and stuff and then like execute their config on a demo that where they played, and that's how you see them play. It was so much effort, but now you just turn on the stream and boom, you can see your favorite players playing in the way that they actually have everything set up. It's really beautiful.
As soon as you said new age, I thought of like purple leggings and red hair.
All right.
Because that's something you used to hear like in the 80s or something, you know?
Yeah, I know. I feel super old when I
yeah,
said that. That's
I'm
why I said
it's top of the
weird.
Pops now and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so the CTs have one picked early. They are on the their last eco here before they go for the full buy.
Pop. Love it. So looks like they're going to get their NT towards the B bomb site, which is exactly what they want. There's actually a player still hiding in the bomb site. Look, it's Valens here. Will he be able to get anything sneaky off here? Oh, he's actually going to peek out just at the right moment. There's another player there to be found, and in fact, they might be able to just backstab him at the same time. This is going to be really annoying. Hey, he's going to turn around and deal with that that flank, though, from Vent.
Bomb is going towards the A bomb site, and the CTs have committed to the B bomb site. So, not that the terrorists will know where they both are at the moment, but it looks like they're going to slowly push into the A bomb site. Let's see if the CTs can recover their position in time.
And look at this. Valens not only made a frag, and of course, there's already another frag on going for them as well, which is already a win of its in of itself. He's actually threatening if they try to actually come and take this AK from him that he could actually get more frags here, which is, of course, great economic damage. But even if he doesn't, then he keeps the AK, which is a pretty big win as well. So this is a really nice round here from Valens, and honestly, Savage are really keeping Netcode guys, you know, under a little bit of pressure here when it comes to the economy. It's not by any means a free few rounds for them, despite them getting the 3-0 scoreline here.
Let's see what happens here. Valens doesn't have any armor, so one or two shots to the chest will eliminate him as well.
Oh no! Oh no, he went down. Unbelievable. And all because he kind of like snapped, like paranoid, like freak, just started shooting because he thought that they knew where he was when they couldn't.
Yeah, well, he may have heard some footsteps on the site. The guy was running fairly close to him, so, you know, just trying to get some pre-fire in. But the pre-fire also pinpointed his own position and cost him the gun there, so no one-shot headshot for him. He'll have to go for an M4 this round.
And this is where we get to see the setup here run by Savage. The first like gun setup here. We've seen Dumore over by the sandbags in mid. He's basically alone. No support from short, really. If there was any support, it quickly backed off onto the A side. We're seeing a 2-1-2, and they're very defensive with this setup. I mean, we have the players on B who can't really quickly rotate through the vents or something. Like, they don't have a setup where they have the vent rooms taken, which is often very beneficial when it comes to response times and rotations. And that's something that we see a lot in the European scene these days. And nice little... That goes to the vents.
Yeah.
Interesting.
It's probably a fake.
This is a good movement for the mid-takes as well, because you get to remove the player from that angle. Because that can be quite annoying to have to look at white box sandbags, then the CT mid-main, and then the vent as well. It can be quite nice to eliminate position there.
It has a second purpose of allowing you to push the vent later on in the round as well, as you're seeing here, without the CTs knowing that they're doing it because the vent's already been broken.
It's pretty hot stuff, and we see JD coming in the back here. Oh, missing a shot there. There finally does remedy that issue. In they go for the retake here. Bomb trying to get planted still. Netco guys finally getting that bomb down. But there's just three, it's a 3-on-3 at the moment. They're waiting patiently in position here. Some good positions here. Ooh, nice little shot there from JD. Very, very crucial connection there. And now they still have three angles to worry about. Had they been able to eliminate one of those players, it could have been doable, but
check.
They're deciding to call it and say, okay guys, we're gonna fall back, save the AK. I think that's a smart choice now. We can check this money situation here, that they are dead broke.
Yeah, in that particular situation, once this terrorists have got into positions off the site to defend the bomb, 3 versus 2, it's going to be very, very difficult unless you get a really fast pick. So much better to save the AWP and the AK for the next round.
I'm going to see how they actually put that into play as well, because of course their team...
They'll be able to drop two of their teammates unless they go for an eco.
Looks like they are going to go for the dropping though.
But they'll be lacking grenades. So Valens going for the mag 7 option to allow him to get some grenades.
I actually do like this from them because they get to keep the pressure on the economy of Netco guys and keep them within the breaking point of having to eco, like force ecos upon them, and keep the ideal weapons away from Netco guys, like orcs and stuff as well. So I do like that, even though of course we can see that a mag on Valens and a Thanos can do more, but that's fine, that's totally fine.
The swag angles on the squeaky door. And Relics finds himself on 50 HP, Hades on 65. We had an early 3-man stack in mid from the CTs, expecting some aggression from the Ts, but Netco guys been very passive at the beginning of these rounds so far, taking it fairly slowly. But in that sense, they have been giving up mid, although they did successfully take it later on in the previous round. So we'll see what they do with this. Looks like they're going to be going towards the A-bomb side. They've got one player, Tarek, holding the flank from mid, and the rest of them are going to bring the pressure.
Alright, so grenades coming in, we can see the set play, and I love that the Molotov to the back boxes forces the CT player out. They didn't get the angle as he escaped though, but they will catch him in the end, regardless, on the bomb site. People working that forklift wonderfully with the Bama, pulls out the pistol, does get a dig, huge damage done by Dumore there in that position, and it's a 2-on-2 situation here that could most certainly go either way at this point, although Valens is working with a mag, it's not going to work at these long ranges. It's going to be very difficult, very awkward to pull this one off. JD with Nord there, great little flick shot onto Valens, can deal with him nicely as Glorians is left over. And here he goes for the drop, or gets the tag with that AWP, JD. Oh my god, James, I'm seeing JWs all over the place.
Wrong continent, bro.
Wrong continent, bro, JD. He's trying to make me go crazy with his JD, but it's fine. Necker guys go up 5-0. And that was a pretty fantastic way for them to actually save that round.
That was a really awkward position for the CTs at the end because they had to run the gauntlet across the sniper rally with only a mag 7, so they can't even really return fire. So obviously Valens went first and didn't work out for him. Although I feel like maybe his teammate should have gone for the trade kill and being very close behind him, but it didn't happen, and he got picked in up pretty much the end of the round. I mean, the bomb had ticked down fairly a fair bit, so they were up against it at that point. That was so close.
Very close indeed. They've been tweaking those wallbangs quite a lot in recent times, but there's Cutler going to be aggressive into the vent room, take that one over. Very nice movement. And Necker guys looking to pick up a pretty easy round here, but as I said, that Valens is able to actually take down Tarek there. And that's going to be nice of him, picking himself up an AK-47.
See, the he's still going slow. They're waiting for the rotation here. They know it's an eco, so they're opting for the gun rather than having someone with the cap gun planting the bomb. But with only one player remaining, they will put the bomb down, and they know where the position of the last player is. And he may fall sooner rather than later, although he does have the CZ, so who knows, he might get a 3-man spray down.
Yeah, who knows. He is not XM though, but the thing is that if he can get some extra kills, that is a big result already. That's what he's looking for. He's not going to get a great deny there with standing on top of those barrels on the bomb site. And Netco guides absolutely savaging Savage at the moment. 6-0 as we move into the seventh round. We do get the next spy run coming in from Savage. We're seeing a difference in the setup now. We're going to see a scar on Valens.
Oh, we've got the blat auto sniper coming out.
Where is he going to use the blat, James? Where is he going to be?
I'd say A main or B, really. Let's have a look.
You can pretty much use it anywhere on this map. That's kind of the beauty of this map as well. Like, I like the. It's a good choice. It's so versatile.
He's on B.
Let's have a look. There he is. On B, chilling.
But CT's with a decision to make already. With only four people. Again, Necker guys have got an early pick, and they're just falling, dropping like flies now. Valens, it's going to be hard for him to save this auto sniper, but with only two CTs remaining here. And they're going to roughly have an idea of where their positions are based on the picks they've got on this map already so far.
I don't know why you would. I said that they were like already close mid. Like Dumo was playing
it's
close
cool.
up.
It's like
he was playing
like
close
up. The ESL thing going on. We can check the team.
Yeah, we're fucking. We're just getting lucky here now. Like the shit that we're doing is not the right rounds to do it.
All right, so they're calling into question the times that they choose the certain setups.
Just stay mid then.
So that's quite interesting to know. But also we can notice frustration coming in and them not being happy with how they're playing it. So that's not a good sign there for Savage if they want to get back into this. Of course, this is a very expensive round for them, and it's going to take them a little while to recover from this.
He's got to hold on to his gun for dear life. It looks like he may do it unless he gets shot in like 0.1 seconds remaining.
Definitely
manages to get through it. You know that is that the splash jam he's got?
It is, yeah.
That gun on the market is like factory new, is like has a completely absurd price.
Really?
Like for a fairly unattractive skin, it's have a look at the price on the market. It's kind of insane. It's like £100. He's like, I don't know, $160.
I'd like to see Valens like working a little bit more alone, more like mid pressure. Coming in from Savage, because if they were able to get...
Look at that nade did zero damage. What? It did two. It did two damage to Jadia. I don't know, like, you saw that on the radar, sorry, you saw the tracer as to where that nade went. It went, like, straight past him, so I feel like it should have done a hell of a lot more damage than that.
Either way, both teams very passive on mid. It seems as if neither team really cares too much about taking mid control early in the game.
Yeah, Netco's guy seems to be going for the late push on mid when they decide to going for a B split. And it seems to have worked. I mean, it's 7-0 right now, so...
Yeah, I mean, it is definitely... they're pulling it off at the moment, but Savage, I feel like they need to get themselves more presence there. But to hold that fort, you're going to get this push coming in onto the A bomb site. There is two more. Again, working forklift. Only one frag this time. As Netco guys spill onto the A bomb site, as the frag traded left, right, and center. We go to a 3-on-3 situation there, as the bomb is going to go down. Not the best positions in the world, and the CTs are going to be on top of them before they know it. The smoke's not providing the best cover ever. Look at this, just it is open season on Netco guys players. I'm so deep pro, it's unreal. But it looks like they're going to be able to pull this one off, this retake slowly working. Pulling cut the left. And oh my goodness, Cutler, unbelievable. 3 points of health left, manages to take the double at the end and secure the round for Netcode, guys. That's just salt in the wound at this point. They had that round.
What is happening here for Savage? I feel like, I mean, you're seeing the set plays come out from Netcode, guys. Yeah, and it's been successful 100% of the time. I feel like there isn't enough counter flashing once they start, once the smoke starts and they start pushing the sights. They're not being delayed in their pushes at all.
They're very passive as well, generally on their defenses. They're waiting to get hit before being proactive and finding the information and their setups. Until now, I think this is the first time we've really seen someone very close. I mean, we saw someone pushing with a pistol earlier on, but this is the first time we've seen someone with a rifle, but he hasn't really got that much support. And he's just there all by himself. He's going to get two frags here, but he's completely on the lonesome. And in, they're going to go onto the A bomb site. And these angles here get completely shut down. And it seems like Savage are able to have relics. They're able to actually take down one player. But Ingo, Netco, guys.
Tarek will be able to pick up the bomb. See if he can make it to the A bomb site where you can see Levi is just trying to hold position. Or maybe the bomb goes to B, but that would be a bit crazy. So it is coming towards A by A main.
What does he mean, both of them?
Two now. Glorian's going to pick himself off one. There goes the fake there from Tarek, looking for that shot with that AWP. They are so close, it's so dangerous. Great nade though, we'll pick off one. And look at this, Valens is actually, he kind of risked it a little bit, going all like the long way around through door here. And of course, this is going to be really difficult because as soon as he, oh, the door's already open, so that's going to, oh, he's actually going to spot him as well, pulling out the mag. Tarek doesn't know. Valens is going to go for it with the mag. He hears him and he gets the shot with the mag. Brilliant stuff there from Valens. Quite, I mean, the door being open still, definitely very, very, very good for him. Not making any sound cues, very sneaky, and the mag wins it at the end. You would have guessed.
Okay, let's see what Savage can do with this. First round, welcome to the scoreboard, chaps. It is a slightly CT-sided map, so they're not doing best right now, to say the least. They need to really pick up another 6 rounds here, which is all they can pick up. So, wishful thinking, but it's what they need, really. Unless it's going to be one of those weird rounds where everything gets reversed. Levi gets a frag through the smoke on relics. You can see it looks like the CTs were trying to boost onto the top of those barrels, which is quite a strong position, but you know, they got pre-fired, unfortunately. So Valens left with 67 HP. So he's going to be a little bit easier to spray down with those AKs. Nice shot there by Hades on JDM. Straight in his face, and he gets Levi as well. So this could be a second round here for Savage.
Good stuff there from, wow, from Savage. It just, they just walked into the blender right there, and it just went terribly wrong for them. This is the first time we saw one of those set plays just completely shut down from just the passive, you know, just they're just sitting there. But I really want to see more pushing on mid coming in here from Savage. That'd be wonderful. But they do seem very committed to the 2-1-2 setup that they've been running.
I mean, they've been taking control of mid at the beginning of the round. It hasn't really been an issue for them. I mean, we're seeing an early peak here from Netcode Guide pretty much for the first time in mid, but it's been later on where they've just been struggling to deal with basically just the set strats from Netcode Guides here. And
I do really like now that they have two guys in vent room. That's really nice, having that forward position on the B site and the quick support to mid and rotation to A. That's really strong. That's fantastic to see from Savage.
Get the position from number 5 here.
Actually, so they've the vents now.
Quite aggressive positions all over the map at the moment.
And it looks like Vans was able to pick that one off. And he just made it through on time just to back away and survive on 7 health. But he's on the site. It's actually two guys on the site. And the nade will actually take him down there. But meanwhile, they're actually going for the push on A. Little do Savage know. They still have two players fairly committed to B. So this is a pretty good movement here from Netcode Guys. Just havoc all over the place. But the bomb is moving towards B finally now. Maybe perhaps they were thinking the rotation would come in from B to A for Savage. But not the case. They're still on the bomb site. Seemingly impossible to remove. Glorious with a nice little double there to stop that approach by Netcode Guides. And another frag being taken again.
Yeah, we should have gone A
just locking it down until Hayes finally is able to take him out. But it's a 2-on-1 situation. That bomb is well and truly down. And help is on the way. There's no time indeed. But Hayes can be in for a very nasty time there. Relics can take him out. And Savage coming back into this, finding their groove, finding their feet. It's looking much better for them now.
Yep, definitely all to play for. The Netco Guides team still able to almost pull out a full buy. We've got one guy just with the CZ, but that's better situation to have on T side than the CC side.
The Pune's towards white box there, and looks like we're going to get into mid with absolutely zero contestation there, and getting up close as well. Looks like are they actually going to go for any kind of push? It actually push someone straight through mid main to actually the CT spawn area. This is going to be a nasty surprise as they find Cutler, but Hades with a great reaction there, ready for it. And you know they're going for the B split though otherwise, so looking pretty hot. The Netco guys moving their way onto the bomb site. Looks like the pressure will be on to actually get that bomb planted though, but they got the smoke to cover them. So this should work out for the plant situation, but the retake is soon to come in here.
Bomb has been planted.
There does go the bomb.
Yeah, I think Savage may have put themselves in somewhat of a difficult situation here where they basically completely gave up mid, had nobody watching it, and almost got flanked all the way through CC, and then gave up the B bomb right after. Obviously, it's going to be more difficult hold after losing Vent, but they've managed to take it back with the auto sniper, and two of them will survive. And it is 4-8, so the 7-8 could be real.
Bomb has been defused.
Yeah,
are we going to see Nico from Netco guys now? They did get a bomb plant down though, so they could probably force.
Yeah, they're going to go for
absolutely,
it.
Absolutely, yeah.
It's very well played from Savage to bring themselves back, because we can see they weren't just playing. You know, well, it was also just handling themselves as a team well, because we could see there was frustration there. Maybe there was miscommunication. Maybe there was bad calls or whatever. You know, we heard that over the voice. Oh, that connected.
11 HP.
Damn, that hurt.
That's what you get for wall banging. Get wall banged back.
Yep. And Netco guys just setting up along the width of the map at this point.
I just want to say, Glorians has Eminem as his avatar, and he was singing Eminem lyrics at the beginning of the match.
Oh really? I missed that actually. I did miss that. But we can actually see here opening in across the map. You got Levi there watching in case there's any aggressive pushes. We have the mid play coming in as well. Very slow. I mean, right now it's kind of very passive from both teams. They're kind of both peeking in a little bit. I can see you jumping back in your seat there, James.
Yeah, he just got dinked in the head through the wall.
That's
because obviously he had no idea that the guy was just to his left at the timing, and they were just one of them stopped peeking as one of them started peeking, and I think his gun was exposed, which is why he got shot through the head. 34 seconds remaining here, so we just 8, which is definitely a full-on commitment here from the T's. Let's see if they can actually take the bomb site.
Yeah, one towards back box in balance, he's gonna be able to take down one. That's all he's gonna get though, which at least puts it to a 3-on-3, but the bomb should be going down, or maybe not. Gets taken down before anything can happen. And JD and Levi left. Netco guys, Levi quickly is back to the there. Not before Glorians flank him. And straight grenade there onto the bomb spot. Trying to catch that sneaky plant there. Very well played there from Savage to get their fifth round. And then things are definitely looking up for them in the face of Netco guides, who were handing out the ownage early on. And Savage. Right now, I've got a couple more rounds left to go, and if they win this one, look at the money situation right now. Yeah, if they win this one without a plant, actually no, of course, you know, Netco guys can buy a next round no matter what, so it doesn't matter.
Looks like we're going to get the P250 train towards the B-bomb site here. Early stick there for Hades, gets the information for his team. We're going to see two more CCs rotating to the bomb site, but they may not be needed. Kind of does take out somebody with the Juan Dig. But he is not going to kill four
people.
One more round. So Savage have brought this back from 7-0 to 6-8, which is a much healthier score and gives them a fighting chance of taking this map down on the second half. I expect Netco guys will have a stronger CT side than we've seen from Savage. But if Savage can take the pistol, then who knows what can happen.
Yeah, certainly. So we're going to see a bit of a boost coming in here as JD gets himself an angle on that white box looking for the headshot.
Again, that nade does 5 HP to him.
Yeah, it's you got to know how to throw those.
The second nade went behind him and did 27 to his teammate.
Yeah, you got to land them just straight in front there.
Yeah.
It's
Definitely. I think it's because they're probably running when they're throwing them, so they're going too far. So they should look at the VOD and then just maybe do a stand throw instead.
And again, there is the nade for the vents. Clean out those vents. Make the mid take a little bit easier, and also, as you mentioned previously, flush out that vent fully so they can get that B split really going.
Yeah, the fire probably breaks the other side of it as well.
Mm. And in they go. More looking to challenge, but can't quite find the kill. Going to get themselves in that bomb side, regardless, release the vent room. There are two players actually on this side. This is actually where Savage's setup tends to be quite strong. Is that they, once they get in, although that's kind of a problem, it's like a very good move there from Netco guys to know more of the back side there, knowing that Savage like to have a man on that bomb side itself. And looking so good for them now. The bomb is down. It is a. I'm not sure if that's a good plant though. I think that might be a hidden plant. We'll have to actually see as the round progresses here. But that has a really big impact on how you have to handle the CTs trying to retake. As open plants are incredibly tough to deal with on this map. In they go. And could be dispatched by Netcode Guides, who make it 9-6. But Savage, got to give it to them. They really fought back. They were obviously struggling at the start, and they had and Netcode Guides were walking all over them. But they found something. They found something deep inside, and they managed to actually bring it back to a 6-9. Very respectable scoreline, making it very doable, especially if they win this pistol round. It's going to be all tied up. So here we go, jumping into the pistol.
Yeah, that was a reasonable recovery, considering the start. So got their fingers warmed up, and looks like we are gonna have a Glock train towards the B bomb site here, while Cutler tries to go up a slide on the A bomb site. Can Tarek hold here? He's got two heads already. Can he get the third?
He's literally just hit every.
No, but I don't
shot
think the bomb is gonna have a chance to go down here. We got 3v1, although Relic is gonna be in trouble. He's got his one flash, which he executes. Tries to even out the odds, but gets the 1v1. Unfortunately, doesn't come out on the right end of it. So, Netcode guys take the pistol, and this is going to be an uphill struggle for a Savage here on in, I think.
So again, their options on the buy here is either pistol armor, or because they didn't get the bomb down, they have to double eco anyway, or it's like CZ this round and then CZ next
but
round.
But CZ's
no
500
armor.
Now. It's not 300. It's the price of a smoke grenade anymore. So, it's a tougher decision than it previously was.
If they still have 2k left at the end of the next round, it should be fine. But either way, we'll see. Because PD50, that's totally fine as well. We can actually see that's what they've been opting for.
Ooh, those angles. The Americans know these angles on cash. Because you don't see so much of this wall banging from the European teams. That's one difference between the US.
Yeah, actually, we've seen nicer grenade placement as well. Like
yeah,
they've really figured out the angles.
Like you saw at EMS1, people were like, "Oh, Swag is like the master of this door," but that's only in comparison to the European teams.
Yeah.
But we're seeing equal mastery from other American players here as well.
Yeah, it's good stuff coming in. I like the shoddy getting the work done.
Anti eco, big pop on pump, getting those bonus money. <in. laughs>
Getting that money.
Hades, last man here, no bomb, no hope.
Okay, so 11-6 the scoreline now for Netco Guides. So definitely a very, very good result for them. And Savage are going to have to find their way back after this next eco. And it's going to be interesting to see exactly the setups out of Netco Guides when they know that Savage is on a gun round.
Chicken has left the game.
Chicken's left the game.
Yeah, someone called Chicken tried to connect, but didn't happen for Chicken.
Good nade, actually. A big chunk of damage on Relics and Glorians there. And Hayes going to go for another one. It's going to be quite damaging as well. Boom, even gets a kill with it.
Definitely speaking, that was nice.
It was pretty damn nice. Lots of damage done, but the bomb does go down in the smoke. And again, we're seeing the very good smoke placement here from Savage, from these American squads. They really got the placement down on those grenades.
Ooh.
Obviously, being in the lab, you know, spending time working out those angles, it really shows.
That is an anti-eco grenade right there, if ever I saw one. But I'm curious to see if we're going to see more counter flashes from set pushes here on Netcode Guides, the CT side, than we saw from Savage, which I don't think we saw any yet, actually. So I'm looking for the differences in the CT sides here, now that we both have a buy. So So no AWP from Savage on the T side there. We've got JDM64 with the AWP and Neko Guide with two FAMASs.
And there he is, he might just find some action here. There it goes. Great shot. Really been putting in some good work with the AWP so far in this match, has JD.
I like the aggression there through door. They had two people, so there was a trade kill if necessary. So they're just shutting down the map immediately. No, they want to ruin Savage's economy and are doing
two
a good
of them
job about it.
Door,
looks like we're not going to get a pass again. So let's see what the money situation is like for the T's here. Going to have to force it because it is 13-6, so they are running out of time to bring things back on this map.
Alright, so here we go. We get another bike coming in for Savage.
Distinct lack of nades as well. So where, I mean, they do have three smokes. Where you saw those set plays from Nexus guys on the T side, where I think they put the ball down on the A-bomb site, including above where we're looking now with Cutler on the platform. Maybe a bit harder for the Savage team to do that this round.
Interesting to push in this into the door room there. He's actually going to get taken out here, and looks like that could open up the A-bomb site, or at least there's a lot of time left for Savage to kind of let Necro guys kind of stew in the fact that they're like, okay, we need to split up our cover now a little bit more, but looks like Haze is going to be locking it down over by the door. That's not going to be a problem losing JD so early. And Cutler in the back boxes, he's been doing a fantastic job so far as well on the defense. But there, you know, in comes a Molotov to flush him out of that position. He's got to move now or he'll get burnt. And just shy of his position, but he's going to have to make his way close to the bomb site. Gets just absolutely destroyed there by Dumont as they push their way to the bomb site. Just Hades left now against two players. He just took down Hayes, but there you go. He's going to go down as well. And again, I would really like to see more aggression on mid, because once you take mid away from them, if you do like a big five-man push, what a brilliant drawing there. That is an arrow, by the way.
That's a very rudimentary arrow.
Yeah,
it's like an arrow
wireless
from the
mouse, man.
Like 700 or something.
But once you do this mid push, you're able to have so much control here, and you can push the CTs back, and then they have to stay on the site. So you can go anywhere, you split, A split, you can do anything you want, and they have to kind of guess, but you remove the map control from them. This is like really powerful to do. And if they try to challenge you, you can obviously get the angeling and the picks and stuff. And it's usually a little bit favored for the T's, even though their timing's a little bit worse. Unless the T's really bias a lot of players there very early on. It's quite even. So it's definitely something that I feel like if they had that, if Netco guys would have a little bit more rotation time to when they really, you know, execute pushes, it could really be much better for them. But either way, we're going to see this push in through the through the vents into the B bomb site, and Savage are making the frags happen. When all is said and done, the frags are coming their way, and it's just Haze and Cutler left now. And it's honestly, it's going to be incredibly difficult to take this down. And even though it's a hidden plant there, it's not going to matter. As a Cutler and Haze, they're never getting to that bomb, and they're going to go for the runner here and just perhaps get some exit frags, just chill, save those weapons. Some extra damage on the way out. In goes the Molotov there, just be extra annoying. They're actually taking down a few players here. Is Relix going to actually be able to get an angle here, I wonder? Maybe go for a bit of a wallbang. He might just go with the wall bang. No! So close. So, no! Too late. Too late. Oh, that's so close. Either way, it's 14-7 now. Of course, Netco guys just on the brink of winning this match against Savage. And we can see, you know, very, very desperate money situation for Savage there. Obviously, they're able to buy, but not as many nades as perhaps they'd like. And generally speaking, Netco guys with a distinct advantage on the money. Set up here at the beginning of the round here for the Netco guys, making sure to deflect any early mid aggression before kind of backing off towards more dedicated positions towards the sites. And actually over an A, and that's pretty interesting. They do have a guy in the vent room. Perhaps him not spotting anyone in storage actually pushed them to go for that. Not much of a sign from Savage. Goran's making a lot of noise here over towards B storage, trying to keep Netco guys from guessing right now as to the real intentions of Savage. But, oh my goodness. What did we just see, James? Beautiful wallbang there. Dumour as well, going crazy. Florence chimes in as well. It's just one of these there, and they're all taking kills right now. It's just Levi left, and before you know it, it's just game over here for Necker guys in this round. Wow, that was just... I don't even have words for that. That was pretty awesome to see that. It's one by one, falling like dominoes there.
Looks like we're seeing a resurgence here from Savage. They're up against it now. They're at kind of overtime point, if you will. So looks like it's forced them to raise their game, and that was a really nicely executed round there. They savaged, no pun intended, the Necro Guide team and took minimal damage themselves. So that's going to allow them to build a little bit of bank here as they go for a peek on mid while the Lich goes towards door again.
And I like this Taric, you know, sitting in the best, very good position for this reason. Also, you can just help mid, you can help.
Interesting, because seeing how passive mid played in this match, he just ran up mid and shot the vent, whereas you see versus pro, they shoot the CT side of the vent through the shutter and then through. So again, some more differences in the American style of approach to cash compared to their European counterpart.
And a lot of noise being made here over towards the A side of the map, and I think the Necro guys are slowly beginning to suss this out. Of course, Taric has spotted a couple of players here. They should be understand that it's got to be an A here. And you can see from the movement that they're pretty sure about it right now. They've thrown in the grenades, and the push from Savage is coming a little bit too late. All the CTs are already all over the bomb site. They've left one just for safety over at the B side, but now he's going to rotate as well. And the bomb is dropped in the middle of the site. Hades gets one kill in, but four guys left to find. 20 seconds left to do it. It's a tall order for the man here.
Knife?
Oh, he gets his knife!
Boom, boom, boom.
And there you go. Match point now 15-8. Netco guys almost done it against Savage. Savage need to find something special right now. You can see, of course, the full buy coming in for both teams.
No more room for errors here for Savage.
Nothing at all.
This first match of the North American part of our $50,000 league.
Indeed. And here you go, we can see again, it's just very passive. I played for both teams at the beginning of the map. Actually, we are seeing a little bit more aggression on mid. Here we got one player up close. He is over at the vent, so Taric's going to take down Dumour. Being very, very good on this this mid play here. Going to take down another frag. There's one more behind the smoke. Will he get it below the boost? He doesn't find the kill, though. And Valens and Hades remaining for Savage here to save the day, to stop this this impending defeat as it looms over them.
I just can't hit anything, man.
Hades going to grab the frag on Levi and force it to a 2-on-2 as they make their way through A main. They just have to communicate well now. Try to pull this off. One player at the back blockers as they push their way in. Hades going to make the kill there. Wonderful entry. And now the bomb just has to get planted. And Hades is going to have his friend covered. You can see JD going to make his way through A main. Are they ready for this? But they know this is coming. Here we go. We've got JD moving his way through, scoping his way in. Did he just see a pixel there? Saw the shoulder peek. That from Hades. Back goes the grenade to the site and gets the frag there onto Hades. This balance left now, all of a sudden it's much, much more good. Let's get the Hades there with the USB, doesn't find it. Balance will close it out, and Savage hold on by the skin of their teeth for one more round.
That was unfortunate for JDM there. I feel like he could have pulled out his AWP instead of the pistol. Although, I mean, the pistol's going to draw faster than the AWP in fairness, so, you know, there's no kind of wrong decision here. But I think the round would have been his if he had the AWP out instead of the pistol. But then there's that time fight for you. So it's 9:15 here. Netco guides forcing... Savage forcing Netco guides on an eco. So, you know, if they can keep winning the buy rounds here, then we may see overtime.
It's a long road for them, though.
Yeah, it's a long six rounds with no errors.
Definitely. Look at this. Look at Levi there. He's just waiting for that 1D. Waiting so patiently. He wants it. Boom! He gets it on Glorens. And that's good. That's satisfying. It's got to feel good there.
Interesting that we've got 3 5-7s as opposed to 2-Z as well. I think the CZ, it has become more of a choice on T to replace Ooh, nice. To replace the Tech 9, because the 5.7 has proved to be a very valuable weapon.
And Levi here waiting on the bomb site with that trusty Deagle. Lurking there. It'd be great to see him pick up another frag or two with that. It's a very difficult position to do it. Support there, gets a couple of tags. Oh, he's so low, doesn't quite find the kill though. And Savage to win another round, of course, you know, losing two players there, but it's no sweat. They still, you know, more than good enough to buy. And we've got Netkugo still on match point, and in comes the buy from them.
JDM back with the AWP, let's see what he can do with it. And we've got Hades picking up the AWP as well.
And they go into their positions. We have a very standard setup at the beginning of the round. There's two players into mid, one dedicated mid player with the AWP, and the support player just running on through just in case as a quick play through mid.
Savage offering nothing in mid at the moment.
Yeah, it's just completely empty out there.
Yes, it will. If they don't take it later on in the round, it will make their pushes of the bomb fight a bit more one-dimensional, but
yeah, it's
doesn't mean failure. We'll see how it goes.
It's taking mid just obscures. Obscures the options that you're actually going for completely from the CT. So that's the biggest benefit, I think.
Ooh, and being tagged, 24 HP remains.
Always love this little.
That's nice picking there from Cutler.
Yeah, it's really nice. It's free spotting. I mean, they can nade it and stuff, but he should be able to get out of there if he's got good support. And we know that they like to play like a heavy support style, like three players often on A. And once they've really sussed out, there's not much going on in mid. They really do like to play down short as their mid guy down short, like we're seeing here from the site. And it seems as if Savage are going to be trying to get in the site. It's very awkward. It's a bit of a struggle, but finally they're making their move in here. Savage, can they take the kills here? Can they get the entries they need? Down goes the AWPer. Cutler with a double, just cutting them down. Three in a row, looking for the quick go with the AWP. Not going to find it. Valens, though, will get taken out. And that's Netco guys, 16-10 over Savage on cash for our first match here for the FACEIT US edition. And all right, that was interesting.